Charlotte, you've driven all the way from Grantham.
I have.
And I started seeing some of your content on TikTok. It's holistic medicine type stuff. Holistic healing.
Yeah.
When did you start it? Why did you start that?
My TikTok or the journey?
Whatever. All of it.
Oh, okay. So my holistic journey, I started about 5-6 years ago. Because I was diagnosed with fibromyalgia.
Okay.
I was also...
Which is what? I hear this all the time on things. Does this help with fibromyalgia? What exactly is it?
So it's a chronic pain disorder disease. Yeah. So your entire body is in constant pain. It's different variations. So some days you can be okay. You can be sat here, but in pain, but it's bearable pain. So you learn to live with it. It becomes a normal. But then you can have flare-ups where you're in excruciating pain. So even just being in bed with a duvet, just a sheet touching you is painful. It feels tender and sore. Constantly fatigued. You wake up feeling like you've not even been to sleep. You get brain fog. So you're just constantly like fuzzy-headed. Don't remember your own name. Don't know what you're doing. Like constantly. There's loads of different symptoms. IBS is one of them as well. I used to wake up in the night with like... I could only describe as being stabbed in the arm with a boiling hot poker and the pain radiating down your arms. Your hands are just open. There's so many different symptoms to it. I was diagnosed with that after years of going backwards and forwards to the doctors. They were doing blood tests to... It's a process of elimination is how they give the diagnosis. So they test you for all other things. And then if you're all clear on everything else, then they're like, okay, there you go, you've got fibromyalgia.
Can you remember back in the day when people used to get diagnosed with something called... Is it ME?
Yes.
Which again was one of those kind of, we've tested everything. We don't really know what's wrong, so we're going to lump it into this.
100%.
So it's similar to that because, again, and I don't know if it's just because I'm naive or because social media is massive now and that's all we're watching. I'd never heard of fibromyalgia maybe 5 years ago. Yeah. Never heard of it. So maybe it's just that. So is there a cure for it?
Well, no. If you're in the doctors... They just give you different medications. So you have pill after pill after pill.
Yeah.
And they warn you when they give it to you. It's probably not going to help. You'll need something else. Mm-hmm. So they're just constantly giving you more and more. And for me, it was a case of they'd give you a concoction of something, wait a little bit, and then you'd get new symptoms that you'd need new medications for. And it was just that constant vicious circle. So they said they don't know a lot about it. They don't know what triggers it. They don't know the causes. They don't know how you can heal it. They literally know nothing about it.
And what is it? Is it an inflammation type?
Apparently not.
No.
But I went alkaline, did like an anti-inflammatory kind of diet, and that was a huge part of my healing.
Right.
But I believe that's because I started healing my gut. So your gut is like your second brain.
Yes.
So when you heal your gut, everything else follows.
Yeah.
So that's what I believe. But then there's so much research now that there's some research that shows it's autoimmune. There are some research that shows it's connected to your gut health. There are others that show it's connected to your diet. There are some that shows it's connected to stress and traumas. And that's how I went into the holistic approach. So I was taking everything and healing everything, if you like.
And are you completely... Completely.
Yeah. Well, I've not had any flare-ups or any symptoms for over 4 years, almost 5 years. But I'm aware of my body now and my triggers.
Yes.
So like last year, I had different weekends away. And on those weekends away, I would completely out of routine. So I'd eat junk food. I'd drink alcohol.
Yeah.
I'd have everything you shouldn't have. And then on the way home, I'd be starting to feel awareness again of my body. Not pain how it used to be, but just an awareness. So as soon as I felt that awareness, I knew that that could be the start of something. So I instantly cut it, stop it in its tracks. So it's never flared into anything.
So, wow. Yeah. So my brother, he was down here the other day. His son, he's 24, 25 now. So he went through... He was on the tracks to becoming a professional footballer. He was played for a club called Ilkeston Town, went through their academy, had trials with Derby County. So he was a very good footballer, but then got something called ulcerative colitis.
Oh, yeah.
Which is, sort of a horrendous IBS, isn't it?
Yeah.
And they went down the medical route. Doctors were, yes, it's IBS. Try this steroid, try that steroid. Nothing worked. Yeah. And he went painfully thin. He was on here the other night. And I think he said to me he went down to about 6 stone.
Oh,
now,
wow.
This lad is taller than me, so he's about 6'1". He's he's very athletic. So he's probably sitting at around about 14 stone now. So for him to go down to, he looked like a skeleton. And the doctors essentially said, look, there's nothing more we can do for him. So he wasn't playing football, he wasn't able to work. So his mum went down this route of looking for alternative methods of treatment. And they came across an American chap whose wife had gone through this, and he'd sort of cured her by a little bit like what you were saying, trial and error with different foods. And so it was a lot of money they paid for him, but they got this sort of personal service. And through this process of elimination of certain things, he's now 100% better.
Absolutely.
He's playing football again. I think he's going to get signed up by a big club quite soon, because he's doing very well at about two levels down from like League Two stuff. So she went down this route, and subsequently now they're very anti everything.
Yeah, me too.
So they were very much, none of them got vaccinated.
Yep.
But they, you know, they've been down many rabbit holes.
They all link up. When you start going down one,
yeah,
it takes you down
a
lot.
Yeah. Which is, have you read The Real Dr. Fauci?
No, but I do know a lot about him. I've looked into him before.
It's unbelievable. Now, whether what he's saying is 100% accurate or not, if it isn't, he would have been sued a long time ago.
Yep.
So on my TikTok channel, I quite often like to challenge these conspiracy theorists, because I think you can, if you're not intelligent enough to be able to decipher between what somebody that spent their entire life studying is telling you compared to a bricklayer from Hull who watched a documentary on the earth being flat and now all of a sudden is an expert on it, or a little bit like when the pandemic hit, all of a sudden everybody was, you know, professors of endocrinology and, you know, all of these things, and you're thinking, hang on a second, you've just watched a couple of things. Now, so I like to challenge these people, but yeah, that book's a good one. It really is an eye-opener.
I think it's good to challenge, because then you can see things from both points of view then, don't you? So then you can make your own decision up and look into what you like for yourself, whereas rather than just accepting what you're told instantly.
Yeah.
Which is why I started looking at things differently.
Yes.
To what we are told is normal or the right thing.
Well, ultimately, and I was listening to, it's a really good episode, it's the latest Joe Rogan, and it's by a left-wing political kind of guy. Pull it up, see who it is, Ben. And he goes into talking an awful lot about a lot of these things. And ultimately, the doctors are essentially paying or being paid to put you onto medication.
Yep.
Dave Smith.
So that's the latest one. Really good.
They're legal drug dealers.
They are legal drug dealers. And I've been fortunate enough in the past with my tennis to teach a few doctors, and you know they will prescribe you a drug that, and I don't know if this is absolutely factual, but they're on a tiered commission system, so they'll go, right, try this one then, Charlotte. And that one doesn't work. So then they go down the line, and it might be that the cheapest one was the one that was going to work, but they go through this da-da-da-da-da because it earns them money.
Yeah.
And they've got targets, and they're getting wined and dined by pharmaceutical companies.
Absolutely.
And I say to people, you know, the biggest conspiracy is money.
Yeah.
Wherever there's money, there's corruption.
Absolutely.
And whatever it is that you're looking at, just follow the money. Whether it's politicians, whether it's big pharma, whether it's whatever, who's earning the money? And it's them that are controlling the narrative.
I'm 100% with you.
Yeah.
Absolutely. That's what I've learned over the last, years since I went holistic.
Yes.
Absolutely. Especially with the doctors as well.
Yep.
I have big issues with them.
but again, you know, there are good doctors out there.
Yeah, I've been
that
told.
That mean well.
I've never met any myself. My family.
I think sometimes what we forget is they are probably medicated themselves.
Yeah, this is true.
They are in debt.
That's crazy, isn't it?
Family problems.
Yeah.
They've gone through all of this. They're just normal people. And we've both had shit days at work, and you can't be arsed with it. And it's